Hey guys, TCC back here for the video, guys. Today we'll be opening up some Ghosts from the Past. Now we don't just have one box, we have two boxes for you guys today. So as we go through these boxes, guys, I'm gonna try my best to go ahead and improve my quality as much as possible. I do have a obviously camera pointing right into my hands. I also have my live face cam, and I also of course have my better microphone, because I've been using my iPhone microphone, and I'll be honest, my iPhone microphone is not the greatest, guys. So, gonna try to improve that a tad bit in these videos, and yeah, let's get right into it, guys. As we are struggle city, as you guys know, opening up these boxes. I did cut a little slit in there so I could make it a little bit easier on myself, but you guys already know it's struggle city sometimes. Okay, I'll be honest. There's sometimes where I'm just like, you know, it just isn't not gonna go my way. So let's go ahead. We got a little tab right here. I always forget about that, man. Literally, I opened up the gold one and I opened up this one and I keep forgetting about the stupid little tab. So how these boxes work is it's three packs in each box. Each pack, I believe, contains five cards. Yes, each pack contains five cards, and yeah, so we get a little lucky. Again, like I said, I'll have the prices of each card on the screen as we pull them, so you guys will see me going ahead and, you know, how much these cards actually go for, because some of these cards actually go for a decent amount. So first one we have here is Dragon of Esset, and okay, decent card, decent first card. Now, I don't really know the crazy prices of these cards, in all honesty. I'm not like up to date with the newer Yu-Gi-Oh. I'm more up to date with the older Yu-Gi-Oh type of stuff. But we got Mass Change right here. Okay, decent. Next one we have here is going to be Fresh Sissart. And again, I'm going to mispronounce all these names. I'm just going to tell you right now, guys, I'm going to be mispronouncing a lot. Dragon Unity Alma Graham. Okay. Not a bad first pack. I will say, again, like I said, I'm not sure what I expect from these cards. I just saw that you could pre-order this bundle of this box, so I was like, all right, we're gonna bring up two to the channel, man. We'll bring two to the channel, see what they contain, see what we can pull out of them. Maybe it's something good. Each of these boxes retails for $19.99, so it's about $40 for both these boxes. Am I expecting to make my money back? Obviously no. I'm not expecting to make my money back, but I'm just hoping I get a little lucky as we go through here. And here's some old Yu-Gi-Oh, man. That's an old Yu-Gi-Oh card from back in the day. I miss that card. Definitely. Like I said, whenever I see, you know, some older Yu-Gi-Oh cards, I'm like, all right, this is more my time, my generation type of stuff. I don't want to call myself too old, but you know, when I was young was when Yu-Gi-Oh first started. So I grew up with Yu-Gi-Oh, grew up with Pokemon, that kind of stuff. So I know a lot when it comes to that kind of, you know, time. But okay, not a bad second pack. Again, like I said, I don't know if there's any cards in this set that's going to give you like a $100 return on your investment. I don't think there will be. There might be, especially if you get some ghost rare cards, but I don't know. Like I said, I've not looked too much into this set to really break down the most expensive card from the set. I mean, there probably is some really expensive cards. I think I might, when I'm editing this video, I might go ahead and post on the screen the most expensive cards from the set, because I don't know off the top of my head, but I have to assume there has to be something expensive. Like, there has to be something a decent value. So far, you know, so far it's decent. Right here we got Dragon Unity. I probably said incorrect, but definitely Laval Archer. Okay. Not bad. Now, like I said, I'm pulling a lot of the same like type of cards, so I'm gonna guess that this is more or less, I want to say more or less for like a theme deck, but I kind of feel like it is kind of like a theme deck with some of the cards I'm pulling. It kind of feel like they probably do work together, and they're probably like different cards that summon the same kind of cards, you know what I'm saying? So let's see. I'm gonna struggle city on all these packs. I'm gonna tell you this right now, these boxes, these packs, I'm gonna struggle city on them. You know, I should just whip out my nifty knife, but you know what? Nah, man. I'll end up messing up anyway. So let's go ahead and just, you know, using the knife is great and all, but I don't want to risk damaging any pack. That's the worst thing that I think you could possibly do, is actually hurt a pack. So we're just going to get a little bit smarter here. Let's go ahead and get these open. There we are, boys. And now we have three packs, like I said. Let's go ahead and start off with the first pack. And let's go do a little tear. Man, I'm not trying to ruin the pack, but listen, I'm trying to get these cards out. And the last thing I want to do is ruin the cards. I like keeping the pack for, like, you know, just like looking at them. And, you know, these packs look definitely awesome. Like the card art on the pack, it look absolutely card art. Anyway, though, first card we have right here is Dragon of Tenuf. Time Thief Regulator right here. Not bad card right there. We have Photon Thrasher. Okay, I'll take that. That's not a bad pool. Like I said, I don't know the price of any of these cards, but I'm hoping they're good pools. Okay. I don't know how to say it. Metal Foes, I guess. Yeah, Metal Foes. That's probably right. We got Sunavalin. Again, I promise I am trying to say these cards correctly, the names, but it is definitely not my strong suit, okay? It's definitely not my strong suit saying some of these names. Tell me down below, guys, if you can say every single one of these names correctly. I mean, I get like, once if I saw it, like getting back into Yu-Gi-Oh to a point, like I could say all the OG's names. Like, some of these names, people like, wait, what's that name? And I can say all the OG names, but the newer cards, I'm still kind of on the fence about, like, you know, knowing their names correctly. So I might just get like more kind of like just completely involved in Yu-Gi-Oh again, and we'll know all the names. Anyway, though, we have this bad boy right here, Sunavalin. Okay, not bad. It's called last card in the pack. So guys, we are now down to our final pack today. And so far, I don't know, man. I definitely think I lost a lot of money with these packs. And like I said, the point isn't to make money whenever I'm doing pack openings. The point is to go ahead and just, first off, buy content to you guys, show you guys these cards, but also to go ahead and just add to my collection. I'm trying to get my collection back. I sold my collection in the past, stupidly. I'm just trying to get some collection back. So I actually showed off my Yu-Gi-Oh collection on this channel before I sold it. So definitely go check that out if you want to check out my whole entire Yu-Gi-Oh collection. But what I'll say about this card right here is pretty much just like a trap card and a monster card combined. And I kind of forgot that this is actually a thing in Yu-Gi-Oh now, where it kind of has like a monster card and a trap card. Very, very interesting. Definitely something that we did not see back in the day. Like I said, connecting everything to back in the day, right? Because back in the day is when I actually played. Nonetheless, though, right here we have Dragon Unity Draft. Okay, not bad. And our last card today is a red Supernova Dragon Draft. Oh, I think I messed up on that. Yeah, I think I'm, yeah, Dragon, not Dragon Draft. So I was thinking about the last card's name, and then I said that card name. My bad, anyway. Supernova Dragon. Ooh, that looks beautiful. That looks absolutely gorgeous. That has to be going for something. Has to be going for something, man. Has to be going for something. I don't know, guys. Tell me down below your thoughts and opinions, though. And if you did enjoy this video, hit the like, subscribe button down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.